the gusto, keep getting that provo. It's high tech, on the track like Flojo. Bet you ain't even know I had flow though.
Yo, make you rock your body.
It's the 2K Sports Pregame Show, brought to you by Kia.
Hello, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson, welcoming you to 2K Sports. Always a pleasure. And I mean...
Well, the weekend has officially begun, and we welcome you to this 2K Sports presentation of
You can never underestimate just how important depth is for a team, Brent. These are the games where you really start to see which teams have the strongest, sturdiest benches.
You also have to commend, Kevin, coaches that have a deep team and are willing to call upon those guys. And to see them step in and perform right away, it tells a lot about those coaches and what they've been doing during their practice time to establish that confidence and get results immediately.
So here is Miami's starting group. We've got Bradley. Chris Bosh is out there with Johnson. Then there's Dragic, and it's Johnson in at the center filling out the middle. Back to Randle. Shot clock at 5. Yep, that one goes. Randle's got the scoreboard going with his first points of the night for Los Angeles. Now let's send it over to David Aldridge, who was able to talk with head coach Luke Walton.
Well, Kevin, he said for them to be successful, they have to act like, and I quote, a swarm of angry bees, unquote, every time the ball goes into the post. If you don't, he thinks they're going to be in for a long night. Kevin?
Thank you, David. Russell against Dragic. A drive by Russell. Randle no good.
And on an open look like that, he's very gifted at making the weak coverage play.
Dragic kicks to Johnson. Tipped.
In addition to being superb on offense, Ingram is also a ridiculously good defender. His long reach really allowing him to collect a good number of block shots.
And it's Bradley. That time on the assist by Johnson. On defense, Miami. This game coming on the heels of their win against the Kings.
And Kevin, you know, they showed how important it is to have a strong bench. I mean, when you are on the road, that depth is vital. I think they really utilized the second unit to extend their offensive assault and just really wore down their opponent.
Absolutely.
Look at that jam.
Wow. Way.
I mean, just beautiful.
And Kevin, who says a point guard should look to pass first? I mean, not when you can finish like this fella.
Well, he wasn't going to give that opportunity up to a teammate.
And that's what we're seeing more and more. Point guards who can finish as well as they make the play.
That Kia Slam Cam replay really gave you a good look at the action. Los Angeles shooting their first free throws of the evening.
Shooting two.
Free throw good, Russell. And so Russell hits them both.
And the thing about Laker fans, I mean, they've always been used to their team being the favorite to win most nights. Lately, though, it's more about the excitement that their young players bring to the game and hopefully the bright future ahead.
Bosh against Randle. Down to five on the shot clock. No good from Trogic. Jacks up a three. Rebound by Johnson. And thinking about the element of excitement that the Lakers bring, it's about watching their tremendous athletes who also happen to have a lot of skill, too.
It's a different kind of showtime for the Lakers. I mean, it's the joy of watching the young guys grow up and the pain of seeing them make mistakes. One thing we can say about Tinseltown, though, it's never boring.
No. This is his first free throw of the game.
Numbers this year at the line below 70, so when he's getting to the line, not nearly as effective as he'd like.
That's good from Johnson. Johnson drops them both. And in this first quarter, about 3 minutes played. Guarded by Bradley. Pass to Randle. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two. Lakers shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
Julius Randle.
Shooting two.
And he makes the first. Well, you look around the NBA, so much turnover in the coaching ranks. I think I read that since the end, Brent, of the 2012-13 season, only about six or seven coaches have remained with the same team. It's a tough, tough job.
It's a very difficult business, Kevin, and I think a lot of the younger ownership groups, and we've had a lot of ownership changeover as well,
sure have,
are not willing to be as patient with the coaching staffs that they put in place, and that doesn't allow guys to develop in the same system over and over. I always think about DeMarcus Cousins in the first few years in Sacramento, seeing five or six different coaches for him and having to learn a new way to play each time a coach comes in and moving him around the system. It's very hard to find consistency, not only with a team, but with an individual player because of so much changeover.
You sometimes see more patience in other sports. That doesn't seem to be the case in the NBA.
And I think one of the reasons why in the NBA, Kevin, is you know this, two or three guys can make the difference between a team that's not competitive and then all of a sudden flip the switch to becoming a playoff caliber team. So it has to do with the personnel. In the NBA, players can make all the difference.
Good point. Johnson, it's deflected. Here is Nance. Taking a look at his stats, he's averaging around 7.5 points a game. Russell dishes to Clarkson. Nance, a screen on Bradley. Right wing, Ingram wide open from outside off the mark. The Heat have gotten 3 of 8 shots to fall for them here in the first quarter. Beverly against Russell. Shoots from the right block, and Beverly finishes it off. Beverly's got his first basket. Lakers have gone 2 of 6 from the field. Russell kicks to Randle. Back to Russell. That one is off.
Well, he had the perfect opportunity to finish that one, guys. Just flat out blew it.
Reza passes to Beverly. The shot off that time. And the Lakers going the other way now. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Blazers.
And that was one that just got out of control for them. And when the lead got big, it almost seemed as if they just mailed it in.
Yeah, I'm not sure I'm even going to go that far, because I think it's a case of two teams on very different levels. And once they got into that big deficit, there's no way they were getting back into it.
This guy is a beast on the board.
And when he gets those second chance points, G8, he does not waste one of them.
Well, you love the NBA, but some of these guys have the DNA. He also outworks everybody. Filthy combination.
Takes it from 10. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Randle's got three rebounds now in this one. Kicks it to Russell to end the drought. Drills the three-pointer. Russell's got 5 points so far. Bradley. No good on that last second attempt there. So at the end of one quarter of play, still a close game. It's the Heat leading by a point. Live from the Staples Center, you're watching 2K Sports. Welcome you back. Glad to have you with us as more basketball is on the way. During the break, the players getting refueled with Gatorade. Looking amped up and ready to get going once again. And when you consider how the Heat are doing, guys, what jumps out to you stats-wise?
I just think that from an intensity standpoint, their defense has really been the key. It's been the catalyst as they've been able to disrupt their opponent's offense.
Relentless ball pressure, jumping into the passing lanes. They're just forcing them into ridiculous mistakes.
The Lakers trade. One thing that Coach Spoelstra doesn't get enough credit for is his attention on the defensive end. Brent, rarely do you see a team he is in charge of struggle on that side of the ball.
I think Spo has so many different ways that he can deploy his defense and gets very creative with the way he uses his active big guys out on screen and rolls. A great defensive mind in the game.
On the court for Miami here in the second. Mills out there with Patrick Beverly. Then it's Trevor Ariza. Then it's James Johnson. And it's Lee in at the pivot spot manning the middle. That one is off. Goran Dragic is checked in for the Heat. Good on the second free throw. Clarkson with the ball. He hasn't scored yet. That I'm sure will change. Teardrop shot. Miami grabs the miss. Last time they met was in Miami.
Yeah, and last time they faced off, really an easy win. They put together a pretty complete game, but their edge on the glass, for me, still stands out.
Yeah, they rebounded better than the U.S. economy, and that turned it into a blowout victory. They were dominant on the glass.
And I love the way he uses his size there to make sure he gets that board.
Young with no one around. Good on the three-point shot.
That's the kind of D that you're not going to find success with, guys. They've got to get a hand in the face.
It's Dragic with the drive. He gets it in there. Dragic has got his second basket of the night.
Awesome drive from Dragic there. Simply put it up and put it in.
Hit by Mozgov. Young outside. Mozgov a screen on Ariza. And here's Young from the arc. Good D by Ariza. The Heat with the lead. Feeds to Mills. The three. The rebound by Young. For Los Angeles, they've gotten only one of their first four shots in the second quarter to drop. No good. He's off to a slow start. 1 for 4 so far.
And this quarter, he has clearly been off the mark.
Here's Lee. Excellent D that time from Robinson. Los Angeles has gone 1 of 3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. It's going to be out of bounds. Los Angeles will retain possession.
Yeah, that's a super defensive play. If that gets through, no doubt they score.
Well, coaches always tell you, if you take a chance, you better get it.
Tarik Black, he's checked in for the Lakers.
shoot it.
And it's off the back rim, no good.
I tell you what, the defense should send Christmas cards for that miss.
And Mills kicks to Lee. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. Well, people always say defense wins championships if you're running a team and trying to craft a lockdown squad. Brent, what are you actually looking for?
Do you have Kawhi Leonard's mobile number?
I've got it. Yeah, I'll pass it on. Yeah, it begins with Kawhi Leonard.
That's what I'm looking for.
A two-time defensive player of the year.
A great positional defender on the wing is an absolute must. And then the back line of defense, Kevin, is an interior defender who not only is a rim protector, but just a great position player. You look at Tim Duncan, and even in the latter stages of his career, he's able to put himself in spots on the floor where he knows he can be effective. Not about blocking the shot or taking the charge, but just in the way of the offense. So I always look for a guy on the back line who can bark out orders and hang around the rim to bother everybody coming his way.
I hear wingspan, I hear length. They talk about it in the NFL secondaries. Length is such a big deal. In the NBA, that becomes just as important, if not one of the most important defensive tools.
Length, and then also knowing how to use that length,
yes.
Kevin.
We're just over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. Ariza against Young. And there's the pass to Zubats. Four on the shot clock. Ball's knocked loose and stolen by Ariza. Here's Lee. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. Let's bring out the 2K leaderboard to see the best up-tempo teams in the league. In third, the Lakers.
Yeah, I mean, they've got the athletes to run the break all game long. So that's their edge. They're always looking to take advantage.
Free throw good, Lee.
And they're really getting more points at the free throw line here in the second quarter.
He hits both from the stripe. Quarter number two, around 3 minutes gone by. There's a good screen. On its way from Young for two, and Lee pulls it down. Lee's got his third rebound on the night.
Yeah, this is a terrible start for him, and it has to be weighing on him.
No good from Dragic.
Well, he's a great finisher around the rim, but some stellar defense there stopped that from happening.
Shot to end this cold run, and the layup is good.
Now that's where you like your shots to come from.
Well, he leading by three. And Mills kicks to Lee. Good ball movement here by Miami. Johnson dishes to Dragic. And there's the 3-second violation. And here we can now take a look at how the ratio was between the threes and the twos last season for the Lakers.
And the long range game, a staple for them offensively. It's clear they embrace the value of that extra point and spacing the floor, something they look to do every time they're on the court.
Lakers have gone just 2 of 8 shooting here in the second quarter. Pass to Zubats. Back to Clarkson. That one's in. His first bucket of the game. He's 1 for 2.
He knew what he wanted to do all along. The teardrop.
And Miami calls their first timeout of the game.
Just trying to get a break in the action to clear some heads here. I mean, they've gone ice cold, and not a bad idea to give them a little quick breather.
Well, take your breather, but then come up with a game plan or a set that produces something high percentage. Let's get back on track.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles. Larry Nance has checked in for Charik Black. Ingram comes in for Nick Young. And D'Angelo Russell subbed in for Jordan Clarkson. To the inside. Here's Bosch. Nance with some nice D. Lakers have gone just 33% from the field in what's been a cold second quarter for them. That's 3 of 9.
Love to see passes to guys on the move that are on target. They don't break stride.
Right side Bradley. Miami no good on that time either.
And the rebound battle split evenly thus far.
And it's Ingram missing.
And you know what? That's one of those heat checks if he's taking shots like that.
And even though he's been on a roll tonight, that one was a bit forced.
Johnson, the pass to Beverly.
Yeah, looking up at the scoreboard, guys, that's his third foul, and his coach has to consider now sitting him down.
.112 left in the first half. They swipe it.
Wow, you watched the defender, and it looked like he knew that was coming. He made a quick play on it to intercept the ball in the passing lane.
No good on the three. Miami's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. To the middle, and Chris Bosh with the slam.
Oh, nice explosion to the basket by Bosh, who wastes no time in throwing that one down.
There's 47 seconds left to play in the first half. Russell against Beverly. Here's Zubats. How's that for an answer? Right back with the dunk. A lot of give and take between these sides early.
And both teams look like they came to play. We should have a good
one. No good from Bosh. The Lakers in the lead. Dishes to Russell. Releases from 15. Rebound by Johnson.
And really no excuse for him missing that one, guys. He has to knock that shot down.
Just a great job of attacking on the break.
Yep, he got up ahead of steam, and no one could come over to stop him.
Russell kicks to Ingram. Here's Zubats, and he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And Miami called for the foul. The Lakers have looked good at the line tonight. They're perfect in four attempts.
And they've been ordinary on the season as well, just about 75% from the line.
And he knocks down the first one. One is no good.
And you can see that even though he ties the game up, disappointed he couldn't give him the lead.
So a tie game here as we finish the first half. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, Goran. How would you say you guys have done in the first half?
I mean, you know, we are battling, we as a team, and if we're gonna play like that, I think so we're gonna be okay.
We'll see what happens in the second half. Thanks, Goran. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, for that interview. And we'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hi again, everybody. Ernie Johnson here with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. A competitive matchup for the Lakers in the first quarter. Some good action during the period, as it was just a one-point game at the end of one. The second quarter was a tight battle, but they were the slightly better team. Not by very much, however. And let's get your thoughts, Kenny, on the Lakers.
I love the motion on offense. Guys are moving, the ball is moving. It's a very nice approach to the game. And one the defense absolutely could not keep up with.
And over to Shaq. What'd you think about Miami?
Aggressive. I called them up earlier. I like it. They're taking it hard to the rack, dictating the pace, setting the physical tone. You're not going to get that by launching threes all night. Everybody knows that.
And that about wraps it up, as the second half is just moments away. Now down to Kevin Harlan and the rest of the crew, and we will see you after the game, won't we?
Yes, we will.
Yes, we will.
We have a close ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half of basketball. You look at D'Angelo Russell, what a contribution.
And even though the defensive pressure and attention was squarely on him in that first half, yet he's still able to be the most effective player on the floor.
Yeah, I just love the fact that he takes pride in his game. Those things keep him motivated to operate at this very high level every time he's on the court.
Third quarter action getting rolling right now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor. Taking a look at Los Angeles. Ingram and Randall, the young forward tandem. And there's D'Angelo Russell, and it's Zubats in at the five, roaming the paint. A drive by Russell, and that one drops for him.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Rogic kicks to Bradley. Johnson left side. And then Johnson with the jam.
And that's how it's done. I mean, find that hole in the D and then go hard to the rack.
Maybe that hole was a little bigger than it should have been.
Especially in a game that is this close, every possession counting. That was just one side wanting it more than the other. Dragic is very good with the basketball, but it seems like he's even better after he gets pressured. He does not dribble himself all that often into situations he can't find his way out of, either with the bounce or with the pass.
First free throw is good. And with Dragic and his lack of turnovers, Brent, it's one of the reasons why he can play both guard positions with ease.
Well, I like how he can be aggressive yet still play under control. That's when he's at his best. When the floor opens up and the Dragon has some space, he can light you on fire.
Agreed. And Goran Dragic drops them both. As the NBA, Brent, becomes more and more of a skill game where versatility is so valuable, you certainly fit that description as a player. You like the way the game is going in that regard?
I do like it, Kevin, and I'll return a question to you and ask you if you think that the skills of the players are just more honed than they were maybe 25, 30 years ago because of their availability to these specialized coaches. This was not the way it was for that generation of players.
Excellent point, but have the rules even enhanced it more that players can show more of their skills now?
Yeah, there's no question about it that the league has tended to go towards being able to allow guys freedom of movement, off-ball movement. The flow of the game is much better. The three-point shot, as we talked about at length, has opened up the floor, and you get to see the grace and athleticism of some of the game's best.
And the basket is good. Got it to go through on the contact, so a free throw coming up. A great opportunity for a three-point play. So both teams changing it up here.
Think back to the first couple years of Chris Bosh coming out of Georgia Tech into the NBA and how thin and slight he was and people wanting him to pack on pounds. All he did was pack on points, Kevin. They all saw his future as a back-to-the-basket big man. That's not what he has become, and he's become an all-star level, maybe even a Hall of Fame caliber player at the power forward position. Yeah, the offense a bit out of sync here to begin the half. They just seem a step behind, 1-4 so far.
Mills with it. He's picked up by Russell. Lock at six. Shoots from 12. And he gets that one to go off the front iron. Dragic has got four this quarter. And thinking about Bosh and him never bulking up, really, he helped shift the mold of what the modern power forward is.
Well, the modern power forward has a good sense of the floor, has to be able to hit the outside shot and handle the basketball. Chris Bosh coming into the league had all of those tools at his disposal, and I don't think it was quite as big an adjustment for Chris Bosh. It was just about how much he could gain his confidence. He did that early.
Here's Johnson, and Johnson with the stuff.
And very little fight put up by the defense as he made his way to the bucket for the jam.
They did seem to take the cautious approach, Greg, when it came to defending that one. You're right.
When you're playing from behind, you cannot let your opponent have things that are that easy. And that was easy.
Randle with the bucket. And here's Dragic. 8 points for him. He kicks it to Mills. He dishes it to Lee. Passes it to Dragic. Soft touch off the glass. Dragic has got 10 points in the game.
Yeah, this is a tough one. The D is giving up way too many open looks, guys, and they're paying for it.
The feed to Mozgov. Randle dishes to Ingram. Back to Randle. The rebound by Johnson. Johnson's got 6 rebounds now in the game.
Solid rebound there, and with the score like it is, that's an area where they can't afford to get lazy.
And Los Angeles with some changes. Tarik Black, he's checked in for Mozgov. Thomas Robinson comes in for Julius Randle, and it's Nance in for Ingram. Trevor Ariza's checked in for Miami. Patrick Beverley comes in for Goran Dragic.
We're still waiting for that first miss from the line this half.
1:53 left in the third. Outside, Russell. And no one near Clarkson as he lets it go. Good, and it's Russell picking up the assist. Russell's got 5 assists in the game. And Beverly kicks to Ariza. Johnson, the pass to Ariza. And it's slammed in by Ariza.
Yeah, I mean, maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that one.
And we know he's capable of those memorable ones. Nance a screen on Beverly. Russell with a wide open look. That one bounces around and comes back out.
Not quite sure why he felt the need to rush that one. He had all the time in the world and just threw it up before he was ready to go.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
To the paint. Pulls up on the elbow. Black, no good. The Heat leading by 11. Lee dishes to Johnson. Back to Lee. Now here's Mills. He's covered by Clarkson. Mills can't hit.
You can't fault him for taking the open look, guys. Just didn't go in for him. But, you know, he'll look to shoot that one again.
And honestly, not real happy with the shot selection on that one.
Yeah, you want your guys to attack with confidence, but that's just a bad look.
And the basket by Johnson.
Just creating havoc for the opponents the last few games.
You saw by that putback there, he's just completely locked in. They're getting full contributions from him right now.
Russell against Beverly. On the wing, Nance. Robinson for 3. And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. Heat lead by 13. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter right here on 2K Sports. Welcome back as we get ready to start the fourth quarter. Not exactly a nail biter here, but you never know. Heat leading by 13. Okay, time now for an injury report.
Well, guys, I was able to talk with the head athletic trainer of the Lakers about his status. It's not what anyone wanted to hear, as it sounds like it's a severe injury. Boy, losing a player like him right now, just a huge blow. They depend on this guy so much, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Boy, you always hate to see anyone ever deal with any sort of injury.
And almost for every player, it's inevitable. I mean, injuries are going to happen no matter how well you take care of yourself.
Well, for how hard he competes in the game, you know he's going to do just the same when it comes to rehab. He may recover faster than most because of it.
On the floor for Miami, they've got David Lee. Bradley is out there with Patrick Beverley. Then it's James Johnson. And it's Bosch in at the power forward. And the first one at the line is good. And good on the second, so he makes them both. Heat leading by 11. There's the dish to Johnson. Bosch kicks to Johnson, and Johnson with the stuff.
That just goes to show you how versatile a player Chris Bosch is with passes like that.
The Lakers shooting a pretty low 34% thus far. Russell against Beverly. Buries it down low. And that's now 11 points for D'Angelo Russell.
And that's the kind of move that will always pay off, even against tight defense like he was facing on that possession.
Well, he really can time those perfectly. What an assist.
And the layup is good. Russell's got 6 in the quarter.
And you know what? He's shaken off the cold shooting performance from the first half.
Lee. A shot missing. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. They'll be hosting Orlando for the next one. And that will be the middle game of this 3-game homestand. Now Russell. 6 on the shot clock. Jacks up a 3. And it's Miami with the rebound.
Yes, so far he has not had his usual effort in this one, and it's really hurting the team.
Here's Lee. Larry Nance comes up with the rebound. Nance has got his 3rd rebound on the night.
And it's tough. His shot's been off today. Luckily, his team still has the edge in the game so far.
Kicks it out to Johnson. It's Bradley on the wing. He feeds it to Beverly. Here's Bosch. Nice touch on the bank shot. Bosch has got the lead up to 13 now for the Heat.
Not everything fell for him in that first half, and now it looks like they're beginning to hit their stride.
Timeout called the Lakers.
You know, he just, like every other coach, can't stand when the defense gives up points on the inside. And boy, are they struggling in there.
Yeah, some of that right now might be a lack of toughness, but you can't combine that with laziness. Guys are not crashing down and closing off those driving lanes.
Just trying to get a break in the action to clear some heads here. I mean, they've gone ice cold, and not a bad idea to give them a little quick breather.
Well, take your breather, but then come up with a game plan or a set that produces something high percentage. Let's get back on track.
Some changes. Johnson comes in for David Lee, and it's Dragic in for Patrick Beverley. Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Kevin, I listened in on what Luke Walton said to his team. He said,
Do you want this game? Don't tell me about it. Show me and show your teammates. We've got to play better, and we've got to play harder if we're going to come back.
Shots are just flowing for him right now, having a really strong quarter.
Bosh, and fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. Julius Randle picks one up.
And with Bosh, he's got so many tools he can beat you with, so adept at the mid-range shot, and he feels right at home at the free throw line.
Shooting two.
First one falls for him. Both free throws good from Bosch. And with the new player tracking cameras they have now, so many possibilities, Brent, as far as studying the game, and I'm sure you think that somewhere, somehow, is going to make a difference on the way these teams are conditioned, how they're coached, the minutes they play, and on and on.
I think what it's great for a coaching staff to look at, Kevin, is with regards to specific plays that you run for your ball club, how it is that spatially your players are relating to one another. You can use these cameras to track the distance players are running. You can track where it is that they're setting screens and how effective they are. The list goes on and on and on. But coaches can really dig into the minutiae of how it is that their players are coordinating with one another with the use of this technology.
That is a great point. And he sinks the second. Here's Dragic.
Defense.
And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
And while Dragic doesn't get to the free throw line all that often, when he does, he's usually pretty good.
At the line for the Goran Dragic. At the line for two.
Free throw good, Dragic. So he hits one of two from the stripe. Lakers trail by 13. Outside, Russell, picked by Randle. Randle, a screen on Bradley. Pass to Ingram. There's the three. They get it back. Zubac, no good.
And typically, he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
And Bradley gets it to go.
You know, huge height advantage there, but because of the great body control, he's able to cancel it out.
Yeah, he absolutely refused to back down there. Crafty lay-in.
Kicks it to Randle, tries to save it. Feeds to Ingram. Zubac, the pass to Randle. Down to five on the shot clock. And again, no good by the Lakers. The Heat leading by 15. Now the pass to Bradley. Johnson dishes to Bradley.
Yeah, easy call.
And the first one drops. Oh. Both free throws good from Avery Bradley. Lakers trail by 17. 1:27 left in the fourth quarter. Here's Russell. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two. Brent, you often see players talking with an official after a call or an on-call. Were you ever able to make headway with the ref by talking to them after a play, whether you agreed, disagreed, or whatever?
Well, the biggest part about it, Kevin, it's all about your approach. So if you walk up to the referees and you're kind and you're courteous, they're going to listen to what it is that you have to say. So it's all about your timing and your approach with the officials to point out something that may be happening in the game or a trend that you see in the early part of the game, just to draw their attention to some of that action during the course of a period.
Did coaches always make players aware of who is officiating and what to look for?
I really never had a coach in a pregame meeting, Kevin, come in and mention the officials who were reffing that game that night. Never happened in my career.
Yep, it counts. And the Heat lead by 18.
And tonight's battle is going to end with a very clear winner, leaving nothing to chance. Impressive win for the Heat.
They had a fantastic play from the bench.
And this team has great depth, and they showed it in this game.
And on the year, this will turn out to be win number 34 for them.
Really, they had their number this season. Two wins, a home win, and an away win. And a great team effort. But still, what an individual performance for Johnson.
You know, the one thing about this performance tonight is the work he did on the rebounding end. He was just a hound for the glass, and nobody outworked him tonight. That's impressive stuff.
Jordan Clarkson, he's checked in for the Lakers. So he comes up empty at the line. And a rule change last season, Brent, in college basketball, allowing players longer to decide whether to go pro and even enable them to declare and then change their minds. I personally like that rule. What do you think?
I enjoy that rule as well, Kevin. I mean, you're 18 years old, 19 years old, and you decide to do something and you can't take it back. I don't think that's a good lesson to teach the youth of America, and so I'm with the rule. I think one interesting thing that we could also look at is if a player comes out for the NBA draft and gets drafted and then wants to go back to school for another year with the team holding that player's rights.
We've seen that before in the old days.
Absolutely. Larry Bird is probably the guy we all point to.
Yes.
Going back and playing his final year at Indiana State and then joining the Boston Celtics. That is something that I think the league is going to think about once again and maybe implement for the collegiate player.
Lee and two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
Clearly a foul.
At the line lead, David Lee taking two shots.
And that one falls for David Lee. And that's good as he hits both of his shots. There's 14 seconds left in the fourth quarter. A nice shot by Black.
And they're on the kind of run that could have made a difference had it just started a little early.
Yeah, it feels like this one's in the books. The only opportunity left is to try and fix some issues that were exposed tonight.
And here's Mills for three and the miss. And so Miami takes this one by a big margin. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't care what the matchup is. You never expect the road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Kevin. Chris, you guys look very confident out there tonight. What was working well for you?
we just wanted to get out of play. We know we're aggressive, and we don't worry what kind of coverages they're in. We get right to our offense. I mean, we're good when we do it. And we just wanted to keep moving, keep the ball moving, stay aggressive, and not get flat-footed, and it worked out for us.
It did look like everybody was in sync tonight. Congrats on the win. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Brent Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. And now, the award-winning Ernie Johnson will take it from here. We'll see you next time.
The 2K Sports Postgame Show.
And Ernie Johnson here again with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. Without further Amir Johnson. Kenny, what did you like about his game?
He was a wrecking ball underneath. His size, his toughness, his strength. Clearly the most physical guy on the floor tonight. But also, he had a sweet touch around the basket.
Listen, Ernie, I don't know if the opposing fans got him riled up or what, but he was out for blood tonight. Shaquille O'Neal, man, he had intensity at his all-time high. He looked like a different player than we're used to seeing.
That's going to do it for our broadcast tonight. We certainly hope you've enjoyed the show, don't we, guys?
It was great.
Yeah. Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, and for Kevin Harlan and the entire 2K Sports crew, all 653,000 of them.
Yeah, it's a lot.
Hardworking.
A lot of people.
Yeah. It's a long line at the buffet, though. Yeah.
Shout out to the T-Poles, man.
Oh, yes.
I don't know
sure.
His name.
The gusto, keep getting that provo. It's hot tech on the track like Flojo. Bet you ain't even know I had Flojo.
Yo, make you rock your body.